Good morning, boys and girls. Today in our ELA, and this really goes for math as well, we are kind of going to have a ketchup and mustard day. Something fun I like to say for we need to catch up on some of the work that we have not completed yet that has come to us in days prior. So I want you to look back at your Seesaw page. That'll show all your assignments for reading and math, and you'll go over to this little activities section. So when you click that, you're going to see all the activities that we have assigned in math and reading. So you're going to want to go through and see if you have completed it. If you're really not sure what you've completed, I can send you a list later today. If you need, we can email a list, but it won't probably come until more of an after school time so we can get to our email and respond. But you just go to your activities and look for ones you have not responded to yet. Because we've got a lot of friends who maybe had trouble logging on in the beginning and missed some things. So this is your chance to get caught up. Also, if you turn something in and it was not completed, or maybe you did half, or you didn't follow the directions, we have sent those assignments back to you. So look for notifications of work that has been sent back, because that means you did not follow directions and maybe you need to take another look at it, or it wasn't fully completed. And we know that's going to happen, especially as we get used to how to complete work on Seesaw. So it's definitely not a big deal. We just want to make sure that you get another chance to try again, because a lot of this work may be graded, and we don't want to take a grade on something that is half done or isn't done correctly. So if you are confused about where to find some information like directions, come back to your ELA tab in PowerSchool and you're going to want to just check out our week of August 17th through the 21st. And you're just going to want to go back to Monday and watch the videos again. They're still up here. They're not going to go away. And go to Tuesday and watch the videos. And then a lot of the videos of assignments and directions are there for you in Seesaw with the assignment. And then we have begun to put to-do lists for each day. So I'll update that for Monday also. But Tuesday's is already up. So these were the three things you should have done in English language arts and reading and writing. So these are the things that are on Seesaw or independent, like read for 20 minutes, that you need to make sure that they are done. Okay, so this is your little to-do list. So you can make sure that you have done all of these things. And make sure you are reading for 20 minutes. That's something we do in class every day. So it's something that you need to do online as well. As we get going some more, me and the other two second grade teachers will post read alouds that you can listen to us reading a book. But for right now, make sure you're reading for those 20 minutes. Set yourself a little timer or just watch the clock. You need to have either a book, like a physical book that you can flip through the pages, or a book on Epic. I prefer a physical book, one that you can flip the pages through. So definitely go to that first, and then maybe another day, read on Epic. You can kind of take turns if you'd like. With math, instead of reading for 20 minutes, with math, you need to be on Dreambox for 20 minutes. The goal in second grade is 5 to 10 lessons a week. So that means you need 1 to 2 lessons every single day. So make sure you're spending that 20 minutes on Dreambox to see if you've done lessons. I have access to your Dreambox accounts, so I get to see on mine how many lessons you've done. And if you click your little, it's got a little icon on your upper left-hand side of your Dreambox. It has a little person on it. If you click that, it'll drop down and you'll see how many lessons you have done. So if today's Wednesday and you have 0 or 1 lesson done, you need to take some time today to catch up on Dreambox. And then definitely make sure you've been reading every day for 20 minutes. That's really the most important thing. Okay? So come back, look back on past assignments, make sure you've turned everything in. Check our social studies science tab because there was an assignment there, you were to watch this video if sharks disappeared, which for my in-person kids, they were so interested in the video and they had so many questions. So it really sparked a great discussion. And then you'll go to the discussion board and you will post what you think would happen if sharks disappeared. So if you've already done that, then great. Once you post, you can look at other people's answers. And you can even maybe send them a kind and appropriate comment like, hey, great idea, or what an interesting fact. So that way you can interact with our in-person kids. So that's really all the directions for today. I really just want us to get caught up, especially for our friends who had trouble getting on in the beginning. If you are mostly caught up, then definitely check Dreambox and make sure you're caught up, and definitely read. If you're caught up, read for maybe even longer than 20 minutes if you can. There are a few new math activities for some story problems. So everybody, especially those who are caught up, can work on those. Make sure you get those done. It is our plan right now to maybe do a catch-up day on Fridays going forward, but I wanted to do one today because I noticed that a few of us are a little behind and I want to prevent us from getting super overwhelmed. So there will be more catch-up days in the future when we see maybe we're falling behind a little bit, because we do that for our in-person kiddos as well. A day or a little block of time for them to do some things that they haven't gotten to accomplish yet. So that's all we have for today. So make sure you're checking all those things. Make sure you're getting on Seesaw and seeing if you have your assignments completed and which ones you still have left to do. I hope you have a great day, and I hope this leaves you for a little time to rest and relax.